In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be done to me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt amongst us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the mercy of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance always remain with us.
Amen.
And may the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Our entrance hymn, Enter the House of the Lord.
Enter the house of the Lord our God. Enter the house of the Lord. Our God who reigns above, sing of his everlasting love, sing of his goodness all our days, come be of one accord. Lift up our voices, sing his praise as we enter the house of the Lord.
Good afternoon and welcome to this Eucharistic celebration.
Good afternoon, Father.
Father.
Within your will, O Lord, all things are established, and there is none that can resist your will. For you have made all things, the heaven and the earth, and all that is held within the circle of heaven. You are the Lord of all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the 27th Sunday in ordinary time. And today is a Girl Child Day celebrated all over the world. And also the Migrant Day. Let us pray in this Eucharist for the girl child all over the world, that they may grow in the fullness of life in our Lord Jesus. That they may, Lord may grant them his love and his grace. And there are almost 89 million refugees all over the world. Let us pray also from them that we may protect them, promote them for their well-being. And in today's readings, Jesus tells us, his disciples, that there should not be any rivalry, jealousy or suspicion as long as all hold the same belief and the same faith. Jesus' instruction invites all Christians who accept him as a Lord and Savior to work together for the common welfare of all, especially the poor, the sick, and the marginalized. If our land has been taken away, how we'll feel? We will also feel the refugees. Let us feel that feeling. There are 89 million of refugees all over the world. And Pope says to promote them, to protect them for their well-being. Let us pray in this Eucharist for all the migrants, also the girl child. Jesus teaches that just as a doctor might remove an infected hand or leg or some other parts of the body in order to preserve the life of the whole body, so we must be ready to part with anything that causes us sin and which leads us to spiritual death. It means that we should abandon certain evil habits, bad friendships, and unnecessary attachment to avoid bad examples and grave sins. Jesus does not teach that we should cut off our hand or foot or pluck our eye, rather using a Semitic idiom. He teaches that the most important aspects of our life is our faith, and it is better to suffer any calamity rather than to lose this precious gift of faith. Let us pray, and for the times we have failed to keep this faith, let us ask God's pardon and mercy.
Lord, have mercy on us soul. Lord, have mercy on us all. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on us all. Christ, have mercy on us all. Christ, have mercy on us all. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. On the soul, Lord, have mercy on the soul. Lord, have mercy on the soul. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on the soul.
Kindly join in singing the Gloria.
Oh, God and Father, we worship you. We give you thanks. We praise you for your glory. Glory, glory, glory to God. Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, take away our every sin, have mercy on us. Glory, glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory.
Manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy. Bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord came down in the cloud. He spoke with Moses, but took some of the spirit that was on him and put it on the 70 elders. When the spirit came on them, they were prophesied, but not again. Two men had stayed back in the camp. One was Elad and the other was Medad. The Spirit came down on them, though they had not gone to the tent. Their names were not enrolled among the rest. These began to prophesy in the camp. A young man ran to tell this to Moses. Look, he said, Elad and Medad are prophesying in the camp. Then said Joshua, the son of Nun, who had served Moses from his youth, my Lord Moses, stop them. Moses answered him, are you jealous on my account? If only the whole people of the Lord were prophets, and the Lord gave his spirit to all of them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, the precepts of the Lord gladden the hearts. Kindly repeat.
The precepts of the Lord gladden the heart.
The law of the Lord is perfect. It revives the soul. The rule of the Lord is to be trusted. It gives wisdom to the simple. Our response,
the precepts of the Lord gladden the heart.
The fear of the Lord is holy, abiding forever. The degrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them are just. Our response,
the precepts of the Lord gladden the heart.
So in them your servant finds instructions. Great reward is in their keeping. But who can detect all his errors? For hidden faults acquit me. Our response,
the precepts of the Lord gladden the heart.
For presumption restrains your servant, and let it not rule me. Then shall I be blameless, clean from grave sin. Our response,
the precepts of the Lord gladden the hearts.
Your wealth is all rotting. Second reading is a reading from the letter of St. James. An answer for the rich. Start crying, weep for the miseries that are coming to you. Your wealth is all rotting. Your clothes are all eaten up by moths. All your gold and your silver are corroding. And the same corrosion will be yours, own sentence, and eat into your own body. It was a burning fire that you stored up as your treasure for the last days. Laborers mowed your fields, and you cheated them. Listen to the wages that you kept back, calling out, realize that the crisis of reapers have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. On earth you have had a life of comfort and luxury. In the time of slaughter, you went on eating at your heart's content. It was you who condemned the innocent and killed them. They offered you no resistance. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation. Truth, O Lord, consecrate us in the truth.
Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Sing alleluia.
Anyone who is not against us is for us. If your hand should cause you to sin, cut it off. The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
John said to Jesus, Master, we saw a man who is not one of us casting out devils in your name. And because he was not one of us, we tried to stop him. But Jesus said, you must not stop him. No one who works a miracle in my name is likely to speak evil of me. Anyone who is not against us is for us. If anyone gives you a cup of water to drink just because you belong to Christ, then I tell you solemnly, he will most certainly not lose his reward. But anyone who is an obstacle to bring down one of these little ones who have faith would be better thrown into the sea with a great millstone round his neck. And if your hand should cause you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life crippled than to have two hands and go to hell, into the fire that cannot be put out. And if your foot should cause you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life lame than to have two feet and be thrown into hell. And if your eye should cause you to sin, tear it out. It is better for you to enter into the kingdom of God with one eye than to have two eyes and be thrown into hell, where their worm does not die nor their fire go out. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, in today's readings, the Lord tells us that whoever is doing good work, do not stop him. When I was in Shirpur some years back, and many are boardings also, there are non-Catholic people, very hardly few Catholic people are there. And there are lots of work has been done. For example, like watershed work, lift irrigation work, borewell work, lots of good work has been carried. And so many other non-Catholic organizations are also there, and they are doing wonderful work. For example, AFAM, the Action for Agricultural Renewal in Maharashtra, they are also doing excellent work. And one day it happened, one Adivasi man, he was staying near the Aner Dam. There is a huge dam there. And they go for fishing there. And this poor man did not know how to fish. And they told him to put a bomb in that dam, that water. Because that is how they kill the fish. The fish come up and then they take and they sell. So this man, his name was Vishram. So he went to put the bomb, and the bomb blasted in his hand. One eye has gone, one hand is gone, and there was a big khadda on his both the cheek. And then our Vishwamandal Seva Ashram, we gave some 10,000 rupees. We took him to Asta Hospital in Dhule, and from afterwards I took him to Gujarat in Surat. And somehow, we were able to save his one eye and one hand. Today, that man is doing his farming with his three children and staying there in Aner Dam. The Lord tells us today, he calls each one of us to do the good work. He calls each one of us to be holy wherever we are. He's saying those who are doing whatever faith they belongs to, whatever the creed and culture they belong to, but do not stop them. Our Lord is good. He calls each one of us to do good works. He calls each one of us to be holy and to walk in his footsteps. The teaching of the Lord gives joy to the heart. Lord refreshes our souls. We all of us looking for encouragement, hope, love in our lives. We want to rebuild again whatever is damaged. In pandemics, we know so many people have lost their jobs. So many of our dear ones have passed away. My own brother also passed away. There are so many people are suffering, no jobs. And we are going through a lot of emotions, psychological, physical. There is so much tension in our lives. But our Lord says, I am there. The Almighty God is with us. Only if we surrender to Him, then He will take care of us. We are going through a lot of psychological, physical, emotional tension. But the question is, how do we sustain ourselves in this pandemic? We have to turn to the Lord. Only when we turn to the Lord will take care of us. In the gospel, we see the Lord is a life. His law is like a light. And if we follow the teaching of the Lord, we will be happy. We will not do the action which will cause scandal. Suppose as a Christians, if we are not following the Christ, we are not following the light, the salt of the earth, then what examples we can give to the other faith? That will be the scandal to the other faith. So therefore, we have to follow the teaching of our Lord. He is a light. Tu hai Krista jaga ki jyoti. Jyotirmay kar sare jaga ko. So in that light, we must follow our Lord. Wherever we are, whatever work we are doing, we have to follow. And we all of us, we know that there are so many people have done good works. There is a one organization called ANIS, Andhashraddha Nirmulan Samiti. You all know the Dabolkar, they killed the Kulbargi, Pansare. So many people were doing fantastic work and they have killed them. But the good work, it will continue and Lord will bless their family and those who are doing the work. Our Lord is with us always. Let us pause for a while and ask ourselves, wherever I am I really doing the work of the Lord?
Let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, and the body and the life everlasting. Amen. The prayer of the faithful. Jesus does not forbid a person casting out demons in his name, nor does Moses stop the two men from prophesying. In both cases, the point is that good acts need not be stopped. Instead, they should be encouraged. Let us now place our petitions before the Lord, saying, your response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy, and the religious, that as leaders in the church, they may encourage the faithful to utilize their talents and gifts for the common good, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may become more prophetic in its attitudes and dispositions, more other-oriental, more loving and more caring, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That scandal managing and exploitation of another's for one's personal gratification may be completely done away with, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That human faculties of touch, sight, hearing, and speaking may be used for the purpose for which they have been created and for not anything sinful, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of us present in this Eucharist assembly, that encouraged by the word of God, we may not feel jealous of people doing good, but may encourage and appreciate the good in them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus, who appreciates the goodness in us while strongly warning against the evil, sins and insinuations to sin by the use of human faculties have no place before you. Give us grace that we may go through the journey of life by following Jesus, who is the way, the truth, and the life. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Novena prayer to the infant Jesus. O Jesus, you said, ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened to you. Through the intercession of Mary, your most holy mother, I knock, I seek, and I ask that my prayer may be granted. Make your petition. O Jesus, you said, all that you ask of the Father in my name, he will grant you. Through the intercession of Mary, your most holy mother, I humbly and urgently ask your Father in your name that my prayer be granted. Make your petition. O Jesus, you said heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass. Through the intercession of Mary, your most holy mother, I feel confident that my prayer will be granted. Make your petition. Let us pray. Dear infant Jesus, thank you for the blessings you pour down on all those of us who come as a pilgrims and devotees to meet you in this holy shrine. As you do to us, open our own hearts also to all those in need. Help us especially to reach out in prayers, kindness, caring and support to the children in the village boardings around. Deepen our devotion to you so that we might continue to be blessed with your joy, your love, and your peace. May each one of us also be a source of joy, love, and peace to others, especially family members, neighbors, and parish community. We make this prayer, dear infant Jesus, in your name. who with the Father and the Holy Spirit live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. I offer to him, O Lord, accept this gift.
Sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O merciful God, that these our offerings may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundation of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the world in all its wonder to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy is the Lord. Holy is the Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord. Holy is the Lord God of hosts. Blessed he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Do this in memory of me." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
My God.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Lourdes, Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that we, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her spouse Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, all anxieties, all unnecessary worries, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Lamb of God,
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to those who receive it.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Our communion hymn, This Is My Commandment.
As I have loved you. my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you.
This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you.
Charity is kind, feels no envy. Charity bears up to the end. Charity is meek, seeking not its own. Charity has faith to the end. This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you.
Prayer after communion. Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within thy wounds, hide me. Suffer me not to be separated from thee. From the malignant enemy, defend me. At the hour of my death, call me. And bid me come to thee, that with thy saints I may praise thee for all eternity. Amen.
By this we came to know the love of God, that Christ laid down his life for us, so we ought to lay down our lives for one another. Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our recessional hymn, I Just Keep Trusting My Lord.
Trusting my Lord
as I walk along.
I just keep trusting my Lord, and it gives me a song.
Though the storms, clouds darken the sky, oh the heavenly trail,
I just keep trusting my Lord.
A faithful friend.
He's a faithful friend.
Such a faithful friend.
Such a faithful friend.
I can count.
count on Him.
I can count on Him.
To the very end.
To the very end.
I'll just surrender to Him. And I'll say, clouds dark in the sky.